Welcome to the Transitions Daily podcast. Transitions Daily is an online recovery group that offers a daily distribution of popular recovery resources accompanied by a secret Facebook group for discussion. We hope you enjoy today's readings.
This is Transitions Daily for March 31st, read by Kurt L. from Albuquerque, New Mexico, USA. AA thoughts for the day. Give thanks. Though I still find it difficult to accept today's pain and anxiety with any degree of serenity, as those more advanced in the spiritual life seem able to do, I can give thanks for present pain nevertheless. I can remember how the agonies of alcoholism, the pain of rebellion and thwarted pride, have often led me to God's grace, and so to a new freedom. Bill W., Box 1980, The AA Grapevine, March 1962. Thought to consider. Serenity isn't freedom from the storm. It is peace within the storm. Acronyms. HOPE. Hearing other people's experience. Just for today. Enlightenment from Bill's story. These were revolutionary and drastic proposals, but the moment I fully accepted them, the effect was electric. There was a sense of victory, followed by such a peace and serenity as I had never known. For a moment, I was alarmed and called my friend, the doctor, to ask if I were still sane. He listened in wonder as I talked. Finally, he shook his head, saying, "Something has happened to you I don't understand, but you had better hang on to it. Anything is better than the way you were." The good doctor now sees many men who have such experiences. He knows that they are real. Alcoholics Anonymous, page 14. Daily Reflections. No one denied me love. On the AA calendar, it was year two. A newcomer appeared at one of these groups. He soon proved that his way was a desperate case and that above all, he wanted to get well. He said, "Since I am the victim of another addiction, even worse stigmatized than alcoholism, you may not want me among you." 12 Steps and 12 Traditions, page 141, 142. I came to you. A wife, mother, woman who had walked out on her husband, children, family. I was a drunk, a pillhead, a nothing. Yet no one denied me love, caring, a sense of belonging. Today, by God's grace and the love of a good sponsor and a home group, I can say that through you and Alcoholics Anonymous, I am a wife, a mother, a grandmother, and a woman. Sober, free of pills, responsible. Without a higher power I found in the fellowship, my life would be meaningless. I am full of gratitude to be a member of good standing in Alcoholics Anonymous. As Bill sees it, to watch loneliness vanish. Almost without exception, alcoholics are tortured by loneliness. Even before our drinking got bad and people began to cut us off, nearly all of us suffered the feeling that we didn't quite belong. Either we were shy and dared not draw near others, or we were noisy good fellows, constantly craving attention and companionship but rarely getting it. There was always that mysterious barrier we could neither surmount nor understand. That's one reason we love alcohol too well. But even Bacchus betrayed us. We were finally struck down and left in terrified isolation. Life takes on new meaning in AA. To watch people recover, to see them help others, to watch loneliness vanish, to see a fellowship grow up about you, to have a host of friends. This is an experience not to be missed. 12 and 12, page 57. Alcoholics Anonymous, page 89. Big Book quote. There is a principle which is a bar against all information, which is proof against all arguments, and which cannot fail to keep a man in everlasting ignorance. That principle is contempt prior to investigation. Alcoholics Anonymous, 4th edition. Appendix 2. Spiritual Experience, page 568. 24 hours a day, AA thought for the day. Since I've been in AA, have I made a start toward being more unselfish? Do I no longer want my own way in everything? When things go wrong and I can't have what I want, do I no longer sulk? Am I trying not to waste money on myself? And does it make me happy to see my family and my home have enough attention from me? Am I trying not to be all get and no give? Meditation for the day. Each day is a day of progress, steady progress forward, if you make it so. You may not see it, but God does. God does not judge by outward appearance. He judges by the heart. Let him see in your heart a simple desire always to do his will, though you may feel that your work has been spoiled or tarnished. God sees it as an offering for him. When climbing a steep hill, people are often more conscious of the weakness of their stumbling feet than of the view, the grandeur, or even of the upward progress. Prayer for the day. I pray that I may persevere in all good things. I pray that I may advance each day in spite of my stumbling feet. Hazeldene Foundation, P.O. Box 176, Center City, Minnesota 55012. My name is Kurt, and I'm an alcoholic.
We hope you enjoy today's readings. You can also receive Transitions Daily via email and discuss today's readings in our secret Facebook group. So for more information, go to dailyaaemails.com today.
Other than the 24 hours a day reading, unless otherwise specified, all quotes copyright Alcoholics Anonymous World Services, Inc., 1952, 1957, 1967, 1973, 1975, 1976, 1980, 1981, 1984, 1985, 1988, 1990, or 2001.